And welcome to Mr. Landry's punctuation lesson. This is lesson number 5 on apostrophes. Lesson 5 on apostrophes for punctuation, Mr. Landry's English class. Today, you will need to turn in apostrophes exercise 5. Apostrophes exercise 4. Apostrophes exercise 4 should look like this. Apostrophes exercise 4. Please make sure that you turn in this exercise at the end of this class. Apostrophes exercise 4. This is required evidence of learning. Turning in exercise 4 being shared now on the screen. Objective for today's class is to continue to understand and gain command of punctuation, specifically focusing on the proper usage of apostrophes. That is our objective today. You should be getting better at usage of apostrophes correctly as punctuation. And turning in worksheet 4 should be evidence of that learning. We will now review our fixing errors PDF. If you remember, fixing errors with apostrophes is an imperative. I would like to review where we started with contractions. We spent time on making plurals, but I'd like to focus briefly on making contractions. So you should see that on your screen now. Use the apostrophe to make contractions. This, I believe, is the most important of all. Use the apostrophe to make contractions. Reading along with me on your worksheet, you should be using this for your homework. Use the apostrophe to make contractions. The apostrophe indicates when a writer has combined two or more words into a single word. Here are some examples. Can't, doesn't, let's, I'm, it's, we've, there, he'll, she's, you'd, and they'd have. Today, I want you to really focus on how you can make contractions, how you can make contractions. Today's lesson exercise 4 focuses more, as you may remember, on another aspect of apostrophes. Another aspect of apostrophes, and that is showing ownership, showing possession or ownership. So when we're doing exercise 4 today, remember, in order to show ownership, something must be possessed. The Seahawks NFL Championship trophy, right? The trophy belongs to the Seahawks. Mr. Landry's English students, those students belong to Mr. Landry's class, okay? So when we're doing our worksheet, exercise 4, focus on how apostrophes, how they make ownership or possession happen in a sentence. All right, it is now time to work. We will spend 10 minutes working on exercise 4 by yourself. You should be working on exercise 4. Now is the time for state staff to provide pencils and pens or copies of worksheets if you haven't already. You'll have 10 minutes to work on this worksheet. Please get your pencils out and begin working. You may pause the video at any time. You may pause the video at any time. You'll have 10 minutes to work. I will leave this screen on with Mr. Landry's rules. You may pause the video at any time. Now would be a good time to pause if everyone is ready. Please pause for 10 minutes and work on apostrophes exercise 4. If you haven't paused the video, you should have paused it by now for work time. If you're restarting the video after the pause, exercise 4 should be completed. And we're now going to review. We're now going to review exercise 4. On the screen, you will now see exercise 4 for review. Exercise 4, a little different than the other worksheets that we have completed before, in that you had to fill in the box with the correct answers, correcting what was implied or simplified with the underlying phrase. So for number 1, I'm going to go through these quickly by copy and pasting. You will see as I go through these what copy and pasting looks like. I am copying the correct answer into the box. For number one, the calculator that belongs to Jeffrey has keys sticky with peanut butter. Keys that are sticky with peanut butter. What did you put in the box? Now, what's interesting about this exercise I've noticed? For some reason, the first one doesn't work correctly. So it'll say Jeffrey's calculator, but won't give me credit, but that is the correct answer. Jeffrey's calculator has keys sticky with peanut butter is how you correct that underlying portion. Moving on to number 2, what did you put in the box? The correct answer should be the stoplight's sudden change. The stoplight's sudden change. Checking my work, you will see it is correct. The stoplight's sudden change. For number 3, Pedro's bad manners. That is the correct answer. You could also put Pedro's bad table manners. Pedro's bad manners is the simple form. For number 4, curling outside the nostrils, the nose hair of Adam repulses Lori, who sits across the table. Adam's nose hair. That's how you would correct it. Adam's nose hair. You'll see what I'm pasting in the box should match your answers. Adam's nose hair for number 4. Number 5. For number 5, the money that Elvis hides in the cookie jar is greasy with butter. Elvis's money, or Elvis's cookie jar money, but Elvis's hidden money. Elvis's money is what we're looking for. For number 6, the stiff bristles on the brush do not apply paint smoothly. For number 6, the answer should be the brush's stiff bristles, something like that for number 6. For number 7, a hungry crow snatched the half-eaten hot dog that Todd abandoned on the picnic table. Todd's abandoned half-eaten hot dog, or Todd's half-eaten hot dog, something showing that ownership for number 7. For number 8, remember, it's all about possession. It's all about ownership. Apostrophe S shows that. How do you create that? The cell phone that Marco uses is shiny with potato chip grease. Marco's cell. Marco's cell or Marco's cell phone ownership, possession for number 8. And moving on to number 9. For number 9, the barrettes that Luciana wears in her hair are antiques from her great-grandmother. Ownership, possession, Luciana's barrettes. Luciana's barrettes, right? Moving on to number 10. Checking your answers as we go. Number 10. At work, the sullen attitude that Harriet demonstrates inspires customers to take their money elsewhere. What about Harriet's attitude? Whose attitude? Harriet's attitude, right? Or Harriet's sullen attitude, but Harriet's attitude would be fine. Harriet's attitude for number 10. For number 11, with their long necks, the giraffes have defoliated the top branches of the trees. The tree's top branches, as long as you show whose branches they are with an apostrophe. The tree's branches for number 11. For number 12, Anastasia. What is Anastasia up to? She's so clumsy. The clumsiness that plagues Anastasia makes wearing 4-inch heels impossible. Whose clumsiness? Anastasia's clumsiness. Anastasia's clumsiness. And for number 13, the dirtiness of the public restroom inspired Beatrice to wait until she got home to go. Well, you go, you know, the public restroom's dirtiness would work as well, but the restroom's dirtiness is why Beatrice just couldn't do it out in public. So, sorry, Beatrice, dirty restrooms. Number 13, the restroom's dirtiness. Moving on to number 14. Number 14, the lack of grammatical control that Nicholas demonstrates translates into low grades on essays. It should be Nicholas's bad grammar, right? Or Nicholas's lack of grammatical control. Nicholas's bad grammar, okay? Something that shows what Nicholas owns in number 14. It's bad grammar. 15. Look at all of those teeth marks. That must be a pencil that belongs to Tobias. Who does the pencil belong to? Tobias. It's Tobias's pencil. Give me an apostrophe with an S. That's the way to do it. Tobias's pencil for number 15. For number 16, all night we listened to the loud party that the neighbors threw. I always wondered, how do you throw a party? Where do you throw it? How do you throw it? All right. All night we listened to the loud party that the neighbors threw. Who party? Whose party? The neighbor's party. Check that. The neighbor's loud party, right? The neighbor's party. Either way, show ownership. Who owned that party? It's the neighbors. That's how you do it. For number 17. So annoying, Erica. So annoying, Erica. The annoyance that Erica experiences every time that Leonard burps at the dining room table will soon mean he has to eat dinner on the sofa. Whose annoyance? And Erica's annoyance, apostrophe S, shows that. It's Erica's annoyance. 18. Number 18. The perseverance that Isabel showed in calculus has paid off with an A in the class. Whose perseverance? Isabel's perseverance, show it with an apostrophe S, and that'll be her A for that perseverance that Isabel will receive. All right, number 19. Number 19. The crusty surfaces of the dishes indicate that Ramsay hasn't cleaned the kitchen in days. Whose surfaces? The dishes, plural, a bunch of dishes, so it's an S with an apostrophe, surfaces. That's how you do it. You could also write the dish's crusty surfaces, but it's just showing who or what the surfaces belong to as the dishes for number 19. Wrapping it up, number 20, you should be grading your paper, making sure your name's at the top. Number 20, the insistent meowing of the cats tells Selena that it's time to feed her 7 felines. Lucky 7, Selena. Who's meowing? The cat's meowing. or the cat's insistent meowing, but just show who the meowing belongs to by putting an apostrophe at the end of the S, S apostrophe, ownership. That is it for worksheet exercise number 4. You should have your name at the top. You should have your name at the top of the worksheet, worksheet exercise number 4, and be turning it in now. Also turning in your paper, if you have any, or pencils, if you have any. Making sure Cottage staff knows this is apostrophes exercise 4. Please put your Cottage name at the top. Please put your Cottage name. Exercise number 4. Next class, study the rules. Please study the rules for apostrophes. You will have a quiz on apostrophes next lesson. That quiz will be next lesson. I will also feature the bonus worksheet, which is a tough one, but the bonus worksheet looks something like that. It's apostrophes exercise 5. Apostrophes exercise 5. If you have a copy, please complete it for homework and turn it in. That is the bonus. Apostrophes exercise 5. We will have a quiz next lesson. So it will not really be a lesson. It will be a quiz. And this concludes Ms. Landry's lesson 5 on apostrophes. Lesson 5 on apostrophes. Please get prepared for the quiz by studying the rules. And until then,